You know, I developed my love of fishing when my dad used to take me fishing.
We're gonna get the big king. Able bags.
Able bags.
And in this episode, I'm taking my boy Shaw out fishing. We've got a little boat hooked on the back. We're going just for a weekend away. And we've got so many plans, so many things to do, and it involves diving. We get in the water and I'm trying to get Shaw onto a big crayfish. We're catching some fish for food, which we love to do. And we decide that we're gonna target a big kingfish out of our little boat. And a little bit of rivalry, a bit of father-son rivalry sparks up there too.
Get the dog.
And I got him on.
Oh, I'm having bite.
Moray eel number 3.
Oh.
This one, doesn't it? How are you doing over there?
Yeah, not sure I want to tell you.
If we really wanted to catch a big kingfish, we were going to have to put in the time. And both big live baits and fishing top water results in a couple of amazing PBs for sure. And just a very cool father and son moment where we came together in our little boat and caught some very, very big fish.
Oh, kingy, whoa, big kingy.
Whoa.
Yep. Oh, on you, sure.
Yep.
Yeah, you got him.
Get ready for the run so he doesn't pull your felon.
Yep.
Well, right now it's the middle of the Kiwi summer. We've just got a stellar patch of weather, so knocked off work early, snuck away, grabbed the young fella, loaded up the Fortuna, loaded up the Hilux, and we're heading away just out of town to a spot. We've got all sorts of gear for all kinds of fishing, and we've just got small boats, but we've got big plans.
We're gonna get the big kingy.
Able bags.
Come on, kingy.
Able bags.
For our weekend away, Shaw and I have been joined by my mate Mike from Hunting and Fishing. He's a keen angler and he's come up from down the line to experience a bit of fishing up here with us. We've only got the weekend to show him around, so we waste no time getting into it. Well, pretty excited about today, really. Not pretty excited, I'm really excited because we've got good weather. We're in an area that I haven't fished much before, so I'm going to be doing some exploring. First real proper fish in the new boat. It's decked out for fishing. We've got a whole lot of light tackle gear on here. Fired up the Fruno, everything's working fine. I'm gonna go and see if I can find some fish and then we're gonna see if we can catch some fish. So stay with us, we'll show you exactly how we're gonna do it.
The big kingy.
The big kingy.
The big kingies.
This cast, I'm going to get him. I'm over the top of your bud, but.
Oh, yes! Yes!
Be interesting. I just said to Shaw, with the sun coming up, these fish have probably dropped off those real shallow flats where we saw them, maybe dropped down into the gutters. So we've gone to the real deep. It's 5 meters deep here in this gutter. And maybe, it is. Oh, it's a good one too.
Oh, it's a nicey.
It's a nicey, boy. Look at that coming up like there. Oh, look at them, how they fight here on the surface. Just, that shot is awesome, bro. Look at that. Oh, yes. I'll just grab him, sure, I think. That is mint. That is mint. Now, if you're gonna keep a snapper, that's your one you'll want, mind you. First fish, tangaroa. And yes, yeah, that's a goodie boy. Happy with that. That was so incredibly satisfying.
We've started off by fishing in the shallows with soft baits, which is not only a whole lot of fun, but it can be very productive.
Oh, nice fish.
We get into plenty of snapper and even kingfish right here in the shallows. But we just don't have room to show you all of it right now. But you can catch all of the action on demand and free right now at ultimatefishing.tv.
Oh! Oh!
And okay. After all of that action here in the sandy shallows, we jump into the Staby 1850 and head down the coast where we suit up and get ready to mix it up and continue exploring, this time under the water.
It almost wouldn't be a nice little summer weekend getaway without jumping in for a swim. It's just, you know, when I go for a swim, I like to take one of these and really, to get some seafood, all you need is some of these, some hands. So we're just gonna have a little hunt around here. We've got a couple of locals that have requested some crayfish, and who knows, we might be able to fulfill that request. And if not, we're gonna have a good old swim and a look around. Okay, doke. Let's go get him. Come on, fullbacks, let's go.
The first thing we come across on our dive is a long-tailed stingray. These guys are not aggressive, and any attack on a human, well, it's not really an attack, it's defense. It's only when they're stood on or cornered. And it's worth knowing that they can't swim backwards. So I approach from behind and just gently move this guy on so we can check the area out for crayfish. And it's only meters away, on the edge of the reef, I spy some crayfish in a crack and I call Shoren to go fetch him for us. This cray is a packhorse crayfish. And while it looks a decent size, the size limit for these is much higher than the reds, or spiny crayfish.
It's too small.
Packhorse crayfish grow big, so we're looking for a decent sized crayfish that's legal, but not too big. Packhorse don't taste so good when they get real big, but this one looks to be spot on. The packhorse gets its name from its wide back, and that can make it hard to get a good grip on. And with a few kicks from its powerful tail, this one wins its freedom. Shaw has shot off to reclaim the crayfish, and he's chased it right down under the ledge and into the cave. But I noticed that this cray's got the jump on him, and it snuck out the back door, and it's creeping away and hiding in the kelp. Ha, I reckon that's fair play, so I'll leave him there and continue on hunting. And here's some more right here. We've promised one of the locals a crayfish, and this one will do nicely. It's big enough to be legal, but not too big for the pot.
Let's take it over to the boat.
Hold on. A few crays here.
Yeah.
Got one for old mate at the campground. Just got a couple of others and let it go. But you want to take one home?
Oh, that'd be amazing.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Easy.
Is it?
Okay. Get it, sure. I must take one home.
Okay.
Okay, you got a mission.
Yep.
Well, mate, I got your cray.
Oh, you're a legend.
Yeah, only she's a big old girl and I just thought I wanted to let it go, though.
Hi.
Get a photo first, eh?
Yeah, cool. Holy.
Yeah, she's got me. Arms are wrapping right around me.
The decision to pack some freediving gear with us this weekend has allowed us to explore a new part of the coast and get underwater, check out what's going on, and find a new crayfish spot. I've popped this big crayfish on the sand just off to the side of the reef. And after first rearing up in a defending posture, it turns and shoots straight back to the reef, past the long tail ray to find shelter. And even though it's going backwards, it knows exactly where it's going because it can hear the reef. As well as navigating by sound, crayfish have an inbuilt compass that they can use on longer migration. And that's pretty cool for something so crawly and tasty. Speaking of which, we need to get a crayfish now that can find its way to our pot. and we've spotted one lurking just outside its crack that looks perfect. So Shaw goes in and makes the perfect grab, and it's the perfect size, right in our keeper slot. So we've got one cray for our new local mate, we've got one for Mike to take home, and now we've got one for us for dinner tonight. Perfect.
We're out of here now, boys. We're out of here now, boys.
But before we head in to cook up a cray and rig up gear for a big day tomorrow, I just want to do a little bit more underwater exploring to figure out if there's any kingfish here. But I'm going to try and do it without hopping back in the water.
Because I don't know this area really, and we're considering whether it's worth coming back here again tomorrow, I just wanted to see whether there was any kingfish in the area. So what we do, we chuck a camera in the back of the dredge. This looks like a score of bait fish. If there's any kingfish, they should at least come and have a look at it. So kick her in the gut, Shaw, let's go. Set the time and we'll sync it up to the plotter, so when we look at the footage later on, we know exactly where we were when we raised the fish.
Me.
So we'll just go and drive over some of these pinnacles here. If there's any kings here, they're going to come up and have a look at us. And we'll get them. We'll get the hoodlums like thieves on a CCTV camera.
Towing this dredge with a camera inside allows us to cover a lot of ground. I'm using my chart plotter to troll over the pinnacles and ledges that are likely to hold kingfish. And as well as capturing the footage, at the same time, I'm able to measure the size of the fish down there on this Furuno DB9 sounder.
Hecky fish on here, 95 centimeters, 97 centimeters. So, too big for snappers, must be kingies.
Well, yes, they were kingfish. And this not only gives me plenty of confidence in what I'm seeing on my Furuno sounder, it gives us some great intel on an area that I don't know much about.
Well, based on the evidence of what's on here, should give us a little bit of intel to look at tonight, decide exactly where we come back to fish tomorrow.
I reckon hit up there first thing, straight line for a big snapper, big burly up, and then kingy in the arvo. What do you reckon?
No, I reckon we should go soft baiting, eh?
Soft baiting. Today we've got a perfect forecast, which gives us loads of options. In fact, there's too many options, and between the three of us, we can't agree what we're going to fish for and how we're going to fish. So to sort it out, we've split up. I'm on my little 1450 Stabie craft, and Mike and Shaw are taking the 1850. And we're going to see just how much fishing we can cram into this last day of our weekend getaway.
So we headed out early this morning. Gonna head out to some fowl. Dad's gonna run some dirty old baits. Me and Mikey are gonna run some soft baits. And I think we're gonna do better than him. Catch a few more fish, bigger fish. It's gonna be too easy.
The soft bait brothers are gonna rule today. It's good versus evil. You watch. The sky's moody. Maddie's gonna be moody, mate, when his baits don't work and the soft bait brothers come home. You wait.
Well, this morning we've shot out to a little bit of reef that I've done a bit of fishing on before. Caught some really big snapper here, some big kingfish here. And just talking to the boys last night, they're all G'd up to fish it, although these guys are super keen to soft bait it. And I'm super keen to get some burly and throw some big baits back. And we couldn't decide what we were going to do, so we've split up, we've got two boats. The soft bait brothers over there are gonna flick their little bits of rubber around, and I'm gonna lob some big baits back into some burly. See what we can turn up. Good luck, boys.
Because everything was bait. We're getting dirty, mate. We don't need a dirty boat.
Nothing like getting a little bit dirty for a big old snapper. Okay, good luck, boys.
Go well.
Oh, and hey, have you guys taken my net?
Yup.
No, I haven't seen your net.
Oh yeah, what net? That's the old snap slayer, that reel, eh? Running from about 7 meters down to 14 meters about where we are. It's running a lot of good sign.
Fish we've been running through, mate, are 50 centimeters to a meter.
Mixed between snappers, kingfish. Hopefully we can get on the board with a few biggies. Get the dog. Look at that, 87 centimeter fish there. That could be my big snapper or a small kingfish. Either way, it's a good sign. It's time to anchor up. Next up, burley. Chunks. Always like to take the scales off of my mullet or anything with thick skin like kahawai. Just makes rigging the baits up a little bit neater and a little bit easier to eat for the fish. And it doesn't, the scales won't foul up on the hook, which could be the difference between that hook going in or not. The old fresh mullet that I caught just yesterday. That's a whole bait right there. The backbone we chunk up, and the head, that's another bait. Three big snapper baits off of one mullet. Oh yeah. Oh, yep. Oh, broke me off, I think, or just
no way.
That was a dog. Oh, out there here.
All right, into it again, mate. Show him who's boss.
Yeah. Just, yeah, broke me off, ran down to the reef.
Oh, no way.
Yeah, one run too, gone.
Bugger. Sure, mate.
Can't be doing that, I'm gonna lock up on the dog. I'm gonna give him a hiding, all right? Watch this, ready?
Eight. Yep.
Got him. Yes. Stop. That's one right here. Pump made, just in case you can pop around. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Pump, 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 pump. Yes, my heat. Oh, lift him. Lift him. This is a proper one. Oh. Oh, okay. Okay, this is it. Oh, yeah. You're not gonna stop him, bro. You're gonna get smoked. Nah, you're done.
Stop it.
You're done, bro. Surely you're done.
Mate.
Bro, this is big. We can't really drop the boat. We've got the sea anchor out.
Pull it in, mate.
Yeah. Do you want to chase the fish?
Yeah. Yeah, keep going that way.
Okay, bro, this is a tough one, eh? Chase him. Do you want to chase him
up? Yeah,
yeah.
Oh, mate, this is awesome. Might be a bit old for this, though. Shows you how much lift you've got through the butt of these little rods, eh? Got colour.
9 metres here.
You'll be able to grab his tail, mate.
Yeah, I'll just tail him. Woo! Awesome. Solid fish. We'll get a few photos of that, eh? You're happy to release this guy after we get a few photos, eh? Yeah. Good start, shot, Mike.
Awesome, my man.
Good start.
Okay, so that's not the ideal start. You don't get those on soft baits, I suppose. Glad the boys aren't here to see that. Ugh. Dry pulley there. Well, I'm fishing two baits at the moment. Got my ton of 6,000 here with 10 kg line, and just over here I've got my ton of 8,000 with 15 kg line. and I've got a panning camera. It's pretty flash, eh? How's the serenity though? Without those bloody soft bait brothers. Can we do another soft bait? Mind you, I haven't even had a bite. Just one more, eh?
Oh, yes. You boy.
Yuck.
Come on, the mullet.
Here we go. Big 9-burrow hook, just one hook and a whole fillet of mullet. And I'm happy. No weight at all, just floating that back in about 14 metres of water. Come on. Well, hopefully the soft bait brothers over there are doing a bit better than me. They seem to be just working that same little area over there, so presumably they're catching fish. And I reckon they're a good combo, those two, because Shaw's always wanted to come back. I brought him here almost a year ago exactly, and he caught his first 20-pound snapper while he was soft baiting.
Get the net.
You know, this is a good one, eh? Do you want to grab that?
Get that net.
Yeah, it's all right. Don't panic, buddy. Don't panic. It's all right.
Get it.
That 20 all day long, bro.
Yeah!
Yeah!
The size of that thing!
The size of that thing! Yeah, I know. That was a Monty one on a soft bait.
Yeah, that's on your Christmas present.
And he just got a soft bait rod and reel for Christmas. Just tried soft baiting out and boom. Got himself a 10 kg, 22-pound snapper, let it go. And for that, he was rewarded with a 25-pound snapper shortly after.
The second one. 20s. Yes, man.
Check that out.
I'll tell you, these soft baits, do the damage.
You got both of those amazing fish just on a really basic, affordable soft bait set. And he fell in love with soft baiting. He's wanted to come back here ever since. I've wanted to fish it with baits. And Mike, he's a through and through lure fisherman. His pedigree is in fly fishing, so he's incredibly good with lures. So those two together will be having a ball. You know, at this rate, I might be switching to soft baits myself. Because at least I know they work here. Still got faith in the mullet though. Come on.
Come on, the mullet.
Yep, loud and clear.
How you doing over there?
Yeah, not sure I want to tell you.
Don't be an egg, how you getting on?
Yeah, not bad. Mike landed a nice kingy. Few bites, but it's not super hot at the moment.
Will you get a kingy on a soft bait?
Yep. Oh, good luck boys, you're doing better than me. I've not had a single snapper bite.
Got two mean morays though, beautiful ones.
Oh, true. He's in the right spot then.
Alright then, yeah, sweeters, good luck.
Go get them ball bags. Get the biggie. There's two here, with your name on them.
Had heaps of weight to it, whatever it was.
Oh, that's good.
Yep. I don't think it's awfully big, but still want to play it just in case.
Just go soft bait, brother.
Small whatever it is, but still it's a fish. It's a nice fish.
Ah, lovely fish, mate.
Sweet.
Nice job. I'll get a picky of him, mate.
Yeah.
Oh, right. Try the ballyhoo. They're kind of like a piper, but oilier. If you can imagine a piper pilly mix of ballyhoo. And I like them because they're quite a bit tougher than a pilchard, so they last a bit longer. And the snapper like them. The old fresh mullet. Right, something appears to have picked up the mullet head. Eat it, boy, eat it good. Eat it, boy, eat it good. And I got him on. Oh yeah. Oh, if that's a snapper, it is a stonker. Doesn't feel like a snapper though. Look at this bloody shark. Bugger. He's pulling the boat around, whatever it is. Bloody shark. Don't get these on soft baits either. Well, it's gone around the burly pot. Here he is. Ugh. Oh, he's a big tope. Look at him. Oh, yuck. See you, buddy. So far between morays and sharks, I've showed you everything that's bad about bait fishing. But stray lining can be really awesome, honest. You don't get morays or sharks with soft bait, so. I feel like I'm the fall guy for this episode. Well, I don't know how many times I've said it, lots. You will have heard me say on the show, the spring and summer, when the water's warm, that's when your snapper are out predating. Because it's in warm water, they don't need to worry about burning up too many calories. That and there's lots of bait fish around for them to eat. In the winter, when they slow down, they go into scavenge mode. That's when you want to be burlying up. So I don't do a lot of stray lining or bait fishing, in fact none really, in summer because of that theory. And here we are again, looks like it might well be the case. Really want to be drifting and lure fishing, but I'm going to stick to my guns and see if I can't pluck one out, a decent one at least, using the old bait and burly trick. Don't get this with soft baits either. But I do love my bait fishing, it's my favourite. But I do like to catch them though. Which kind of isn't happening at the moment.
Oh yes.
Oh, it's a snapper too. It's got the good jiggle.
What were you saying? Just about starting to come right, eh?
Still got the kingy drag on. Just button this off a little bit.
Oh, reckon she's net worthy?
Yep.
Okay, that's good. I'm not going to get the net out yet. I don't want to jinx you.
No, don't do that.
Got colour. Yeah, she's a snap.
Come on, Rod. Do the damage.
All right. Oops. Oh,
it's a poor eye. Oh, that's cool.
Holy, on soft bait.
Those blue fins. Oh, happy with that.
Yeah.
They're all big too, eh? Nice. Oh, that's a ripper.
Get a phone.
Yeah. How's that? Not every day you get a poor eye.
Especially on soft bait.
Yeah. It's a screamer. Look at those scales too. Put up a cool fight. Good boy. Come on, flick that tail. Good man. It's clear water, eh?
Oh, I'm having bite.
Yep.
Nice. Oh, jiggle wiggle, mate.
Might be a John Dory. Please be a John Dory.
No, no. No, oh, granddaddy.
Granddaddy helped, eh?
Hooked him.
Snapper. Oh. Yeah, it is a snapper, isn't it? Okay, not very big, but snapper nonetheless. At least that's what it feels like. Could, nah, another granddaddy harpica. Far out, I'm,
oh, you gotta stop.
I'm slaying these things, man.
Oh, it's a goodie too.
Yep. Might have foul hooked something, I don't know. Oh, bugger, just dropped it. It was a big one.
What was it?
Big granddaddy harpica, was massive. Probably another bloody granddaddy harpica. I'm pretty good at catching them. Yeah, it is too.
Here we go.
He's in. Might be another one.
I think it's what we're after.
Oh, look at the shark.
Whoa. What kind of shark was that?
I think he's a bronzy.
Boohan.
That was our meter 68 on the sounder.
Oh,
here we go.
Oh,
well, we're after at least, eh? Just need a bigger version.
Snag.
Hey, hey, hey. Oh, you're kidding me.
Moray eel number 3.
Wow.
Oh dear. Not good. Oh, and I'm snagged. A bloody shark eat my bloody burly bag too. Jeez.
I'm out of here. I'm out of here. Might go soft baiting.
Oh, look at this. We gotta try something else.
Trolling time. Kahawai will equal kingfish. Almost guaranteed.
Okay, bait, come on. It's a nice wee kahawai. Even the kahawai are hard to catch at the moment. It's only one of those days. It's beautiful weather conditions, but there's no birds, no activity. So I figure catching some live baits might just be the thing that can turn it around for us. Well, turn it around for me anyway. Yes, boy. Yes, boy. We got bait. Go on then, tell me, how many did you get?
Mate, we got the granddaddy Harpooka, who my champion here, and I just got a poor eye.
On soft bait.
It's a nice big poor eye.
You know when you're catching granddaddy Harpookas, the snapper aren't around because they can't compete with the snapper. How many snappers did you get?
Like two or three.
Two or three more than me. Like, I don't even reckon I had a bite that I could even say was a snapper, other than little wee pickers. I just reckon they're not here. It's not like it was last time we were here, eh?
Nah.
Amazing, eh?
That's right, we'll change plans. We'll maybe try for a kingfish. I've just caught a couple of live baits. And we'll give that a go for a jam, eh?
Sweet.
Sweet. I might just need an angler on here for the kingies. Oh, yeah.
All right, there you go.
Okay. Jump on
here
then,
mate. Anything's got to be better for him than granddaddy Harpooka.
Okay. Jump on here and see if we can get something other than a granddaddy Harpooka.
Yeah.
But if it was about snapper, I'm going to have to concede soft baits did it.
Oh well, might not have been the best day, but I mean, still won, that's all that matters.
Won? What do you mean? Who's saying a competition? Do you want to come and catch Kingy or not?
No, okay, fair enough. We'll call it a tie.
Soft bait brothers.
Bait brothers. Bait mate.
Catch you soon, Green.
Come on then, we'll go and see if we can get a Kingy.
Can I bring the soft bait rod?
Bring your soft bait rod then.
Bring the boys.
Get the big kingy ball bags.
Don't you worry about me, mate.
And I'll run the live bait. And I'll shout if we hook up. Well, you'll know. We're fishing good. We're fishing good, mate. That's all we can do. Things swimming pretty good, eh? Bait was freaking out. Bait was freaking. Oh, on my bait. Kingy on my bait.
Yeah,
he's got
yes.
It.
Yes!
Roll the camera.
Yeah, I'm winding in. Yes!
Oh, I haven't hooked it yet. I hope. Okay, it's gonna go to ground. Okay. Come on then. We'll go and see if we can get a kingy. And I'll run the live bait. And I'll shout if we hook up. Well, you'll know. We're fishing good. We're fishing good, mate. That's all we can do. On my bait, Kingy on my bait.
Kingy.
Yeah,
he's got yes. It. Yes! Yes!
Roll the camera.
Yeah, I'm winding in. Yes!
I haven't hooked it yet. I hope. Okay, it's gonna go to ground.
Okay, just play it. You play it until I'm ready. Okay, I've got that camera rolling. Get the dog, yes!
Hard. Just fight.
Yeah.
Okay, you're gonna keep pumping him. I think it was a kingy. Hope it was. Coming up the top like a shark.
It is.
We're only in 13 meters of water, so we're gonna see it soon.
Give me gloves.
Don't jerk the rod smooth, eh? It'll go to ground much harder. Okay, if he goes under the boat, it's going to bend while I'm not. It's all right. There it goes. We've got heaps. 15 metres of water now. A little bit of drag there. Actually, maybe well. I still want to make it to ground.
Yeah.
Love that pull.
I love it.
Change of plans. The snapper wasn't working. Put out a little lure called a kahawai. That's why I was so pumped about catching that kahawai, because it leads to this. Well, hopefully.
Yeah, it's king. Here it is.
Okay, it's a nice one too. Oh, it is a good one. Jeez, my goodness. Just don't wind anymore.
Okay.
Just don't wind it. Let it run if it has to.
Okay.
That is going to run.
Oh, my goodness. Yes.
That's a dog.
Oh, I'll get it.
That's a dog.
Get just, a little cafe.
Now, hang on. Yeah, where? Hang on. Look, look, look.
Oh,
that's a dog. That's a dog, bro.
It's a dog.
Yes! That's a dog, boy! Wow. Yes, my boy! It worked!
Yes.
We got the big kingy, boy!
Got the big kingy!
Yes! You got your snapper last time. Wow. Got the kingy. That's a dog, bro.
That's a dog! Thank you, bro.
I told you, mate. That's what I was catching those live baits for.
That's a dog.
Okay. Circle on corner of the mouth. Pinned him.
Yeah.
He came up and smoked it on the surface, mate.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, that's over 20, eh?
Well, over 20. If it was fat, I would say 30, but it's not real fat. But still, it's a good
25
fish.
25 maybe?
Yeah, it's 25, right.
Yes!
Easily.
What a dog.
That's your photo right there. That's your big dog.
Go. Did he swim? There he goes.
He boosted off. He boosted off good as. And that's that circle hook.
Yeah, boy.
You want to do that again?
That was sick, bro. Thank you.
I know. Only 15 metres of water too, around some gnarly country. We did well to steer him away. First fish for this set. The Speedmaster 12. Spooled it up specially for this trip. Real good value lever drag set on the grappler type J rod. Winning. That's a good start for that set. A real good start. Okay, button off cameras.
Okay. Yes.
That Speedmaster went good. I was impressed. Yeah, might as well cast that sticky ball bagger.
Going hard on that.
Just work it back in, mate. Coming over some bait here.
What colour are you? Oh, kingies.
Oh, yeah, nice. Pack of kingies. Pack of kingies.
It's a big kingie.
Oh, on you, sure.
Yup.
Yeah, you got him. He's gonna run soon, okay? Swimming back towards us now. Get ready for the run so he doesn't pull your balance.
Yep. It's another nicey, I saw it.
Right, give it a little bit more drag, just a tiny bit. Just a tiny bit, all right? Don't let him get to ground. Work him up. Work him up, my boy.
Oh, my balls.
It's good to know you got some though.
Yeah. Ball bags! Yes!
Okay.
There he is.
Okay, I'm gonna loop him to the other side. Not a bad one.
It's a nice one on stick bait.
Kevin's gonna get the pole, bud.
Yeah.
Gonna move him to the other side of the boat, mate.
Yeah, he's on the other side.
Thank you.
Woo!
Oh, don't lift his head out. He's going to get a lift gear and the pole.
Don't think that hook's top three yet. Might want to get that gas, eh?
Okay. Slide him on over to me then.
On top water, that's my first proper one on top water.
That's a proper one too, mate. Well done.
Thanks you.
On the old Shimano stick bait.
That's
one on a live bait, one on a stick bait.
Yeah, boy.
Straight towards the camera. You.
Yeah, boy.
And another one powering away, back from whence he came. And for me, that's the real value of kingfish. Now you can, if you get the right sort of size one, they are good eating if they're in good condition. They've got so much value being in the water. People will travel from all around the world to catch quality fish like that. And I've got to say, I can see why. That's pretty good. When that is really world class, when you've got weather like this, beautiful water, and you see a kingfish come up and eat your stick bait. That's as good as GT fishing or marlin fishing anywhere in the world.
Awesome. I'm stoked with that.
You should be, mate.
Yep.
Yeah, my boy. Soft bait. Good work, mate. You alright landing him?
Yeah.
Oh, mate, there's nothing wrong with that. There you go. Slipping back in the water, mate. We've done alright. And with that, it's just about expired our weekend. So it was good to get away, see some new country, and come back to a couple of spots that I knew would hold fish. Great run for the new boat, and we got the big kingy.
Got the big kingy.
All of the tips that you've seen on this episode, from the baits and rigs, right through to the gear we use, you can see it all, how to rig it up, at ultimatefishing.tv with step-by-step videos. See you next time on ITM Fishing.
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode, but if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.